YouTube. Today we're going to be talking about the song Miss Sun by Boz Scaggs. This is a great jazzy tune and pretty fun to play, actually fairly easy to play. The guitar's in standard tuning, so, and I do have a little bit of chorus on the guitar amp itself. Other than that, it's fairly straightforward. So as before, I'll play a snippet of the song and then we will break it down and talk about how to play this great tune. I can still remember what you told me with your eyes. One kiss, now it's down to this. Guess it's time you tried to hold you, but the moon got in the way. Won't be long before the morning's got you back in my arms. All right, let's go ahead and talk about how to play this great tune. First of all, the guitar's in standard tuning. No real issues there. The song itself starts out in a B flat major seventh. Now this has got a real plucking sound, so I'm gonna use a plucking technique. I'm just gonna be plucking the primary strings, and it starts out on a B flat major seventh. The B flat major seventh is made by putting your first finger on the sixth fret of the low E string, then you put your ring finger on the seventh fret of the D string, your little finger on the seventh fret of the G string, and your middle finger on the sixth fret of the B string. And you're not gonna play the A string, so you're just gonna pluck those other four strings. So it's, you're gonna get the B flat major seventh sound. So it's, and thinking about you. And then you're gonna go to a C. Now you're gonna use the half bar C, and that's made by putting your first finger on the third fret of the A string, and then you lay your ring finger on the fifth fret of the D, G, and B string. And you're just playing those middle four strings. You don't play the E strings at all. So that's a C. So first line is, been thinking about you all night. So that's the first line. The next chord on the first chord of the second line is a G minor seventh, and that's made a bar G minor seventh. You put your first finger over all the strings on the third fret, then you put your ring finger on the fifth fret of the A string, and you're just playing the upper four strings essentially. Okay, and then you're going to be playing the E seventh, but not E seventh in the first position like normal. You're going to play the E seventh up here in the fifth fret. You basically take the C7th shape and you just slide it up to the fifth fret. And you're just gonna play the middle four strings. So it's a little bit of a variation of the E7th, okay? And then, so that goes like this. Guess you got me. It's a little bit off-centered. Got me. And then you're gonna go to an A7th. And that's a bar A7th in the fifth fret. You lay your first finger of all the strings on the fifth fret. You put your ring finger on the seventh fret of the A string, and then your middle finger on the sixth fret of the G string. And just playing the A note, which is the fifth fret low E string, as the bass note. So that second line goes like this. Guess you got me. A7th to a, and then the next chord is a D minor 7th, which is made in the 5th fret, and you're just basically moving that same shape that you did for the A7th down one set of strings. So your ring finger is on the 7th fret of the D string, and your middle finger is on the 6th fret of the B string, and just playing, you're not playing the low E this time, so you're just playing the middle four strings. So you're gonna get the D minor seventh sound. And then you're gonna, there's gonna be a, a couple of stabs in this song, and they're at the end of each line. So the second line has the first set, so you're going to be playing, got me in your spell, oh well. And then you're going to do some quick pass stabs. So the quick pass stabs are G7th, and then go to an A minor 7th. And then you're gonna go back to the B flat major 7th. And so the way that goes together, second line is, guess you've got me in your spell. Now stabs, pause. Okay. And you gotta get the timing on this, because timing's really important. Guess you got me in your spell, oh well. You're going back to the B flat major 7th for the third line. But I think it will be all right. To a C, G minor 7th, E 7th, A 7th, to a D minor 7th. You're going to do another stab, but it's on a C. As you enter the chorus. Hey, Miss Sun. Okay, so we'll wait on the chorus for a second. You just gotta get those stabs at the end of the line. So there's one on the second line of the verse, and then there's one on the third line of the verse. And they're just slightly different. Okay, let's go ahead and talk about the chorus now. The chorus for this particular song starts on, again, the B flat major 7th. Hey, Miss Sun. Back to a C, which I showed you before. What you gonna say? Now it's gonna go to an F major 9th. An F major 9th is made by putting your first finger over all the strings of the first fret. Then you put your ring finger on the third fret of the A string. And then you put your pinky on the third fret of the high E string. And you gotta make sure you're plucking as much as you can here. Trying to get the minor 9th sound. I tried to hold you. And then to a B flat 7th, which is up on the 6th fret, a bar B flat 7th. And the reason you're going up and doing this, because there's some follow-on chords that are actually up in this register in the middle part of the keyboard. So you lay your first finger over all the strings on the 6th fret, and then you put your ring finger on the 8th fret of the A string and your middle finger on the 7th fret of the G string. That's a B flat 7th, okay? And then you're gonna go to a D sharp minor 7th, and that's just by taking that same shape and then lowering it down one set of strings so that your ring finger is on the 8th fret of the D string and your middle finger is on the 7th fret of the B string. And you're not playing the low E, you're just plucking the four middle strings. So you're getting a D sharp minor 7th sound. It won't be long before. And then you're gonna go to an A flat 7th, which is on the 4th fret bar chord, same 7th shape as we talked about before. A flat 7th. So let's listen to how that goes together up to that point. This is basically the first three lines of the chorus. So it's, hey, Miss Sun, what can I say? I tried to hold you, but the moon got in the way. D sharp minor 7th, A flat 7th, to now you're going to go to a G flat 7th, which means you're just taking this shape. You're going down two frets, G flat 7th, okay? And this is kind of a little instrumental interlude at the end of the chorus. To an A flat, which is a bar A flat. Your first finger covers all the strings of the fourth fret, and then you're just doing middle finger, or the ring finger is on the 6th fret of the A string, little finger is on the 6th fret of the D string, and your middle finger is on the 5th fret of the B string. Okay. Okay, A flat. And then you're going to go back down to the G flat area again, second fret. But this time you're going to do a G flat minor 11th. And the way you do that is by essentially doing a G minor 7th, which is laying your first finger over all the strings of the second fret, your ring finger on the fourth fret of the A string, and then you put your pinky on the fourth fret of the high E string. So it's, so you're getting that minor 11th sound. Okay, so let's listen to how that all goes together here for the last line. It's basically a little instrumental interlude at the end of the verse. So let me go ahead and let's see. Let me play the whole thing. So it's, hey, Miss Sun, what can I say? I tried to hold you, but the moon got in the way. D sharp minor 7th, E flat 7th, G flat 7th, A flat, G flat minor 11th. Pause. And then you're going to do a couple more stabs from a D minor 7th to a C. And that takes you back to the verse again. So it's, I can still remember what you told me with your eyes. Stabs, G7th. Once you get into the chorus on the next time, there's an instrumental guitar lead that Boz Scaggs does, and it's I think it's like a pentatonic scale in the third fret. So you're going to have to figure that one out. Listen to some of the recordings to get that cool little, very short, it's almost like a melody lead. And then he goes chorus again. Then there's some vocal ad-lib over the entire verse again. Usually two people are vocal ad-libbing back and forth, okay? And then back to the chorus, and then the song ends. So, a great little tune here. So, let me go ahead and just end it, and you'll see how the chorus ends. So it's... Folks, that's how you play the song Miss Sun by Boz Scaggs, and another great tune, and hopefully that helped you. And as before, if you have any questions about this or any of my other videos, just go ahead and drop me a line, or send it to my email, which is out there on my various videos. So